Good evening, good evening. Good evening, good evening. Good evening, good evening. God bless you, God bless you. Oh, yeah, Wale, God bless you, God bless you. Please just share and invite your friend, share and invite your friend. God bless you as you do that, share and invite your friend. Just share and invite your friend, share and invite your friend, Jensen Faye, God bless you. Please share and invite your friend, today's going to be lovely again. As we all know, we are in the presence of God right now. Please, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. Katie Morgan, God bless you. Evangelist Blessing, Amos, God bless you. You are watching with us. God bless you. Please just share and invite your friend. As you do that, God bless you really good in Jesus' name. Come on to me, all ye that labor. Sharing right now is a little bit difficult. Please just share and invite your friend. God bless you. Share this word. If you look at the heading there, it's going to be a very interesting program by the grace of God. We are cutting off the music here right now. Please just share and invite your friend. Share and invite your friend. We don't want to turn here to be studios as a jolly. God bless you. Please, the only help you give to us right now is just to share. Pass the word around. As I try to do sharing right now from my devices. Please just share. Don't hesitate to share. Share and invite your friend. As you do that, God will bless you in Jesus' name. Share and invite your friend. We all know right now, the only thing that's going to set us free from this recent predicament we are facing, particularly the is most popular in the African continent, is truth. We need to tell ourselves the truth. If you read your scripture, if you read your Bible, we must have to be honest to ourselves. If you read the book of John chapter 8 verse 32, it said the truth you know, and you apply it, it said what? It will set you free. There is one thing knowing the truth, another thing applying it to whatever thing that you are doing. That's why there is a word beneath said, or when I hear matter, bogba, na me we are here fan bogba, e matter, e gya fano. Please, let's do just that. Let's share the word, share the word, share the word. As we pray right now, eternal King of glory, we thank you, Lord, for this hour. Father, Lord, the word that you have given during the meditation of today, you said, son, talk about truth. In other words, truthfulness. Father, Lord, as we deliberate on truthfulness, the lack of truthfulness of what they are doing in our society, Father, Lord, wherever this word is going to go, you say your word will not come back to you void without accomplishing the purpose that has been spoken for. The reason for this topic today, let it be seen in our society in Jesus' name. That is why if you look at our youth today that is campaigning for APC, most of our Edo brothers today, if they want to be truthful to themselves, they know that the administration is bad. If they want to be truthful to themselves, they know that the administration we are facing today is bad. Because there is no truth in them. That is why you still keep on supporting one government that put us in perpetual pains for so long. Because they have no truth in them. I pray that God Almighty will forgive them their sins. In Jesus' name we pray. Please don't hesitate to click that button. Just press that button, share, let it go viral. Let this word go viral. It's not what we need to enjoy alone. This is only the platform. If you are going there to entertain yourself, you can visit somewhere. But when you are going to come and learn, add more value to your own life, then you can come here. That is why most of the time we are not very many that say the truth is bitter. At the times you are able to taste the bitterness in the truth, at the time you are able to taste the bitterness in whatever thing that is coming out of your life, from that moment will be glorious. That's why that ikokolism is where what the truth lies. By the grace of God, we are going to be, as usual, we are going to be searching the scripture word by word, gradually, then we'll be able to say truth today in Jesus' name. Please, sorry for the little bit distraction. I'm trying to share to most of my to my Facebook precisely. I'm trying to share to my Facebook right now so that the people that have not yet seen our message right now, so that it will also get to them, because these days sharing to WhatsApp is a little bit difficult. I want to appreciate as many that are watching right now. May God bless you all in Jesus' name. Your purpose of coming today will be granted for you, all your heart desire in Jesus' name. That's why whatever claims, whatever thing that we are doing, because we are truthful, that's why it took us time to search the scripture. It took us time to begin to study, to show ourselves what approved. Because whatever claims, if I'm accusing anybody today, I might have seen so many lapses in your attitude. A lot of people, when you talk to them, instead of them to admit and really watch out their behavior, there is some certain anger that stirs up in them, because the so-called follower, they are not true. If they have been truthful, if they want to be sincere and be truthful to themselves, they know quite all right that this thing is bad. But the question that keep on coming to me, why is people clapping for things that is not going to make our society to go forward? Why is people clapping for those things that are going to put our state in a state of political jeopardy? Why is people keep on clapping for those things that are going to make our state to be in a state of gadaga? Why is people today, they clap for things even when they know the person is failing, they keep on clapping? That's why I beseech us one time here that we all should look for a coach, not a fans. A fans will clap for you even when you are losing football, because they are not truthful. Most of the fans, they are not truthful. They clap for you even when you are failing. I've given us a practical analogies. I've given us a practical examples here. Even when Spain, they are losing man. Because those fans, the reason why they transported them there was to go and support. Whether we are losing or not, you still keep on shouting. There's a song they normally sing, and that song has no meaning. Oe, 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 oe. It is the word that have been put there. Say this thing even when we are winning or when we are losing. That's where a lot of people today, this is the type of people. That's what I've demanded for coaches. And today, all of you that are watching right now, you are a coach in the mighty name of Jesus. Anywhere you are not be functioning, God will make you to start functioning in Jesus' name. So truthfulness is very, very important. Some of the problems that we have today is that the sense why Lucky Dube said, he said there is no truth in the world. This is a reggae song. He sang it in the 80s. Then he began to imagine upon himself. He began to look at it. There is no truth in the world. Instead of people to see that what they done is what is bringing reproach to them. All they say right now, Benin people not good. That's why I pity people. Then I begin to wonder whether it is the same God that creates me. That what creates a lot of people. What have you sowed to the ground? Have you saw a good attitude that will make Benin to clap for you? Did you have a business that you want to promote that is genuine in our side that you want us to promote? We promote this for you. Okay, right now, when you first of all brought out the plans, was Benin people not beside you? What did you do to the Benin people? You drove most of them away. You called most of them all manner of names. And they are right now folding their hands looking upon you. How you are, because you can fool me one time, you cannot fool me the second time. These are the problems we have. A lot of things happen to them. What you can give is what you are going to be expecting in return. The word receive is called, in the Greek word, is called sieve. It's called sieve. What you can give is what you can also receive. If you can give what good health, you are also going to reap good health. What in return, at the time, you call people your friend and you touch their head. You give them cap and the whole head is scraping. You give them human head to feast. At the time, you know, the old head is put off. You said you are a friend. What about when you become an enemy? What's going to happen? Then you expect, after doing all those things, that many people are the more intelligent people in this world. They watch you. They don't just fall mugu anyhow. They don't just fall into your games anyhow. That's why today, there is a word I will never use. Umagbanedo, I will never use that word. Because what? I am of God. Anyone that is of God overcome what the world. He said, be you transformed by the what? By the renewing of your strength. And look at it today. There have been so many nonsense audio in social media. Benin people. What are Benin people? And you remember you are also Benin person. Then what have you sold? Would you know today? I've proudly said it. If at all I have any problem with anybody, it is spiritual enemy. Nobody have ever one day blocked my name and begin to insult me because all my claims are from the Bible. If at all you are going to say anything about me, if at all there's going to be lapses in whatever thing I've said before, I want to reveal something to us. The reason why at times I call myself I'm not academically balanced. A brother was talking to me. He said, if fiancé one day get annoying, why would this boy, the way he speaks, he sounds very educated. Why is it that you always use this word to humiliate? He said, I told that brother, and I said, that is the only defense I have. At the time I tell you, I'm not that academically balanced, you will not start hunting some of the past tense I'm supposed to use for past participle. You will not start hunting it. That is the secret. He said, let no man boast of himself. I'm not full of pride. I've seen a lot of people today who said they attended Uniben. Even in their profile, it is there. Where I stand in terms of academics, they cannot stand. It does not mean that I'm an illiterate. I'm not illiterate. But I just tell you that because I will not be sound as Professor Wole Soyinka. All those are the people that go to school. I will not be that eloquent. I may not know how to solve further mathematics just the way my younger ones do solve it. They write further mathematics. They will write their exam and write for other person. If I'm able to pass my own weak path, they manage to push me to the next class. I clap for myself because that is my trend. But today there's a great difference. God has given me what? A divine wisdom that the people that services, they need me in order to enable them to achieve their goals, what in life. That is it. If you look at Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11, he gives us different kind of gift. Area where you are buoyant, it may not be the area where I'm buoyant, but we need to what? Live in one accord, in harmony. That's how God has created this life. The hand have its value. The ear have its value. The eye have its value. The tongue have its value. Even this mustache you are seeing right now, it have its value. When the women will be using Mary Kay, at the time I'm able to lie my beard. Before you know, I'm in lines with the fine boy, the ugly boy, whatever you think you may say. That's why a lot of people, the one thing I don't call myself fine man, whatever. The thing people use to kind of, to begin to see themselves in a higher esteem, it doesn't freak me. I've never one day rated myself as one of those fine boys. Then at times I begin to look at someone before you just dread your hair and put ear up on the earring and many, many makeup, some of the men they put in, they still resemble cheap as in. I look at them, why not just target it way? Your mind is your beauty. That's how I look at this line. If you watch it today, so many things have been happening. And these people, they don't watch. Why is these people talking about this very person? Why is these people right now humiliating this person? You expect me that I have served. And the way I was, the coin which I was paid back, it was a back on the old world, we're watching it. What did you expect me to do at the brim of your success? At the time you plead for forgiveness. And that forgiveness should be made of what? Supplication. Confession must be there. You have to make a very good supplement. Please, I'm sorry. Then we go to the next page. And we are going to be giving you a trial whether your repentance is genuine or not. That's why you see the other day, a lot of people right now who came out to say, I'm a changed person. They crumbled already. Good thing doesn't come easily. For you nothing follower, good things. The reason why gold today become gold, it passed through so many processes that bling will not be able to withstand the fire. Before you have been called a nice man, before you have been called that this person has really changed, you might have accepted so many challenges that come your way. That's why today the people that said, I look at the programs that was happening in social media. I look at it as an amalgamation of government that Chief Frederick Lodoga brought to Nigeria in 1914. I look at it that way. That's why I never want to entangle myself with such war settlement. Within myself, I'm letting go of the past. If I'm not letting go of the past, today I will still be crying. But I came last week to give us a reminder. For those stupid followers, I came last week to give us a reminder. This is exactly see. I felt, and I know it, that you are planted, you just dominated. How many people knows about it? Recently, I begin to reason from one stage to the other. How would this person live his life? That's why late Apostle Obama, or where the Ado Sagmonai, or what I to who where I to him, or when keke unyime, or one I can say, that is called akoroi. There is time and season for everything. Galatians 6 verse 7. I know I quoted it last week. I was not supposed to overlay and fasten on it today. He said, don't be deceived. Our God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, thou is shall reap. At the time you sow humiliation, at the time you sow disgrace, disgrace you sow today goes to your future. That is why today I might have made so many blunders in social media. That's why I don't just come out and start humiliating people. I don't just come out and begin to misbehave. I might have misbehaved or go wrong by one way or the other. Those things, what people, when people bring it out tomorrow, I will look at the video again. Oh, I was sorry about it. Not the things you love doing. You always find the coefficient of what you are doing. You begin to solve the maths and you find the answer, you keep it somewhere. That's why there is always correction. There's always correction dose when we are in school. You do this number one, you have to do and do correction. That correction, you study it again and again. You repeat it again and again. You have to keep on, you revisit it again and again. A lot of people, there is no correction in their diary. They make error today. They are going to make another error tomorrow. They are going to make another error in the future. Then the followers are there. Who told you? I was part of those struggle. For you, for those of you that have been making it direct audio, just tell who you are sending the message to and let me come out and reply you with the scriptures. Thank God you can beat the blood. You can beat the word. You can beat the spirit. You cannot beat the blood. That is it. If you look at it today, right now, I'm going to be teaching us today as an apostle of activism. I come in different dimensions. And I want to thank as many of you who have been assisting me in prayer in this race. And you believe in me. And I also will believe in you. We are going somewhere. If you read the book of Proverbs 24, verse 8, it says, an honest answer is like a kiss worth to the lips. An honest answer. At the time somebody asks you a question and you give that person an honest answer and you are giving that person a truthful answer and that truthfulness will not lead to your truthfulness, then it's like a kiss worth to the lips. At the time, for those of us that play lovey, lovey and honey, honey at the time, you know what it takes when your loved one kisses you. It's like you are in a different way. That is what an honest answer do to what to the body. The reason why you see so many things, so many ajagaduism you are seeing today in our society, so many things are not going well. People are faking their friendship because they have no truth in them. And without this, there is no way the continent of Africa can ever go forward. If you see the white man, at times you have been sentenced, you see them in the station, he will say this thing, I did it. That is, it will be very truthful for you. That is why these people, they have really read the Bible. They've studied the Bible and they begin to show themselves approved from a different perspective. The reason why I'm going to do a little bit teaching today. I'm going to be, for those of you, share it among people. Because for those of us that have this archaic mind, if you must have to talk to me, bring your claims out of the Bible where I have fought out from. Just the way I use the Bible to also correct you at times. I will be very happy. That's why blah, blah, blah is going to put you in a state of resonance magnetica. The more you think you are fighting, the more you are entangling yourself into a problem. For example, right now, for those of us that set trap those days, it's a trap, your trap catch animal, particularly the one you serve with wire. Then the more the animal is dragging, the more it's getting tighter. The more the animal is dragging, the more it got more wound. Or let me explain it in another way and again. Let me forget animal and use us as a living thing. When you are being arrested by police and your hand is being handcuffed at the back, the more you drag, the tighter the handcuff become. The same thing people are doing today. Instead of you to go home and think, what area have I fought out? Am I really a problem to myself? Or someone have inflicted the problem to me? I told us some time ago that self-inflicted suffering is what most of us are passing through today. A lot of us, the what we have committed, he is the one hunting for. Not that nobody is driving us. Nobody is after us. Nobody running after us. Nobody want to kill your political career. You have killed your political career by your own self by saying things that you are not supposed to say from your mouth. This is the problem people are passing through today. But they begin to see other people who is only analyzing their attitude. I pray that on a very good day, someone will start analyzing my preaching. You are promoting me the more because people is going to hear a word that will change their life. I pray that somebody will just rise up one day as an opposition. Then you begin to play on my video. I will be very happy if you play my video. The only way I'm not going to be happy, when the area I use, then you use it. Maybe I was supposed to say it mistakenly because of my incompetency in academics. I will use that word whether you value me or not. I will keep on using it. He said, God resists the proud and giveth more grace what to the humble. At the time I keep on saying this so that God will make everything to be bright and beautiful for everyone. At the time you keep on playing my audio, you play it serially, my word will go out there. That's why what God said in the book of Mark. He said, go into all the world and preach the gospel. If somebody helps you to promulgate your past video, clap for him. That is to say, the seed you are sowed by one way or the other have germinated. Why are we hungry? Why are we always furious? Why are we always at times, we are very, very bitter. He said the truth is bitter. But at the time you are able to test the bitterness. I told us some time ago that the use of barbiter in society, the use of the economy use of barbiter or the people that gossip you, is they are the one to let you know that your human head don't tangle. You need to go back. That without nobody barbiting, you feel you are okay. Should I say today, I think I'm one of the most dressed social media presenter, the men. Because if you go there and count all what I've come out with, it thousands and thousands of different tires. I feel I know call that one local because I know what I always go to market to go and buy. I will not intimidate myself for that. So that's it. So let's try to always pull good. And if you look at the book of Proverbs, chapter 28, verse 18, he said, the one who walks in blameless is kept safe, but the one whose ways are perverse will fall into the pit. The one that walks in the way of blamelessness. If you choose to do your work, by not being blameless in everything that you do, you choose to present your program. By one way or the other, try to put in your best to make sure that children yet unborn. Okay, if we generation right now, we are watching your video and we are shedding tears and some fools are there clapping, carry on. Why not make a revival? What is in this video that people always complain of? Why not correct that mistake? A man will sleep with a girl. After sleeping with that girl, you begin to tell people, go and ask that girl how good I am in bed. A reasonable man will not say that. A reasonable man will not sleep with a girl. That if they want to get confirmation on how good you are, then by so doing, you have spoiled that girl marital career. At the time, people know, this was the girl that this man we're talking about the other time. You see that at the time people open that chapter tomorrow now and begin to say you might have fought out in this angle. We are very furious over the things we done by ourselves. He said, whosoever, the book of Ecclesiastes, he said, whosoever that break the edge, serpent will bite. If anybody choose to analyze your video, that is to say, don't make more video that contains so contaminated word again. Sophisticated word can be used at times when you are fighting our political leaders. There was a topic I titled before. I said the reason why sophisticated words should be used for our leader because they have put us in a perpetual agony. We can just say all politicians in Nigeria, if they refuse to change, the one bar will finish all of them. Even people will clap for you. Not using that same word individually for somebody who is suffering the same suffering with you, who have not contributed any downfall to our economy. And if you read the book of Proverbs 6, verse 20, he said, my son, keep your father's commandment and do not forsake your mother's teaching. And if you watch it today, there are so many legacies, there are so many prerequisites that our parents do give to us. What you know that nobody will do to you, you will not. Why doing it to people? These are the area. He say harvest time and season will not cease. That is why if you read the book of Ecclesiastes 3 from verse 1, he said there is time and season. There is a time for you to speak, and there is also a time for the word that you have spoken to be used against you. Then why are we complaining? Why is all this nothing, some nothing followers? Why are you complaining? We all know this was the same fight we fought together. I'm here to correct this impression. If you like, go and hit your head on the wall. This is true. We have to be truthful to ourselves. This lack of truthfulness in our society, that's why today you see so many things happening. It still keep on happening. Even when we say we have arrived, we just embark on the joint because a lot of people, they did not understand what they are supporting. Whosoever you are following, tell the person, change from this thing. I know there is no perfection in humanity. At the time all your video is being watched, no one that is relevant. Let anybody go and follow my video. Go and follow it. Only where you are going to see is misconception in English, which can happen to anybody. And I have a reason why I shouldn't even speak English at all. And mind you, English is just, it does not make you to be intelligent, it does not show you're intellectual. You tune your voice, maybe, and begin to talk like the white. There are whitey that are mumu. It's just a language. Let nobody deceive you with that. Let everybody do the same thing I do. If you know you are versed in Galati, there are some English I use here. A lot of people, even when you go and study Oxford Dictionary, you may not see it. You are going to see it in one of those atlas. Macmillan will read those days. And maybe by now you will only see it in one of those old libraries. not by coming. Maybe a lot of people, they are so eloquent. They speak diligently. When they are talking, you love what they are talking. But at the time they want to instantiate an argument, then you begin to see that they have nothing in them. That's why there was a saying, this word was used. He said, empty vessel make what? The largest noise. So English is just a language, just the way Spanish people speak Spanish. Also, people what that speak English does not mean that they are more relevant in society or something. A lot of people, somebody will complain to me about 4 or 3 people. He said they will complain that I speak too much English. I say, me will not even know. I'm wanting to know more. I will not, because of you, delete you. I know me, I can't talk anyhow. But I have to keep on putting it so proud. He say, practice what make perfect. It does not mean that if we come on social media today, let go to occupy a podium and make a speech. Within 1/4, I'm going to come out in the Oedo. Because of what? Because of the word of God that I have. If I try to underestimate myself, that is to say, I'm trying to say that there is reason why you and I must flow together. If I can underestimate myself, how will I not come? I will be truthful to myself, you know, not to mock at anybody when you made any blunder, rather than to say, carry on, I know you can do it. Proverbs 6 verse 20, he said, my son, keep your father's commandment. What was the commandment your father gave to you? How does your mother train you up at home? How were you brought up? Was Proverbs 22 verses read upon your head that train up a child the way it should go? When it is old, it will not depart from it. That is why today I do make references to my parents. I do acknowledge the absence of my father at times, that my father taught me, because that is true. But if you begin to see some people today on how they live their life, you begin to understand that either they lack home training or they were just stubborn naturally on their own. They don't have what? Self-discipline. Lack of self-discipline is what makes some people to talk anyhow, because something is wrong with their medulla oblongata. There's a thing, retentive memory, that will say, oh, this thing I'm going to say is going to affect. If you do this thing, it's going to affect you tomorrow. What is the need of doing it? There's no need of doing it. So for those of you who have been making audio, Edoema, Unuwa, Okangbelowa, figure out one person and talk to the person. I think I'm speaking for about 3 million Edos. Umagbanedo, Edoema love him, yes, Unuwe, Okangboe. You don't know what you are doing. Don't you know, as you are using this language right now, you are talking to eminent personalities. There are people right now, some of them in Canada, they're a good Edo man. He lived all his life as a just man, but not as a perfect man, but trying to be perfect. Even Jesus Christ said it. He said, nobody is perfect apart from my father, which is the devil. Then if you can come out and begin to condemn food trap, that is to say, woman or human, and buttress that character and let's see the area where you are good. If you can say Edoema, for example, Magbanedo, you but stress your own. Let us carry a spiritual or physical microscope. Let us go and watch your character. Then we find out that you are the bad head inside. Because what you can give is what you are going to be expecting in return. At the time you give disgrace to people, disgrace is going to come back to you. That is why my word is of the Lord. As I'm accusing right now, there's a scriptural basis to also back it up. 1 John, if you read the book of 1 John chapter 3 verse 16, it says, dear children, let us not love with words or speech, but with action in this truth. These are some of the, lapses that we have in our society today. The same people that are saying right now, I love you, let them come and practicalize it and put it in action. Then what we need to call Agbamorire, you will not see them. Okay, this thing we are sharing right now, most of you before you were in this Europe, did I see any of you that is ranting today in one of those protests we did? They did not come out. I flew from Spain. Why not so few from wherever you are? I flew from Spain. I was in the field of advocacy. How me that saw how things go? I'm trying to make a correction. They say, spare the rod and you will spoil the child. I'm trying to make a correction from here. Who is you to start saying Magbanedo? If I catch any of you using it directly to talk to me, I will use you for cheating for good 7 times. A teaching may your man teach. I don't humiliate anybody. I'm going to place you in different verses of the Bible where you belong. And I want people to put me there. I comrade new thing, Benigun, aka the Archbishop of Activism. I stand here to be corrected. Put me in your preaching. The email at the Bible. Where remain la ve me viwala dan we Bible now. Where remain la dan we be no one. This is the only book that we have. And it has been sustained every one of us. This is the only book that our pastor today, they are flying private jet upon. Then what are we talking? Let us be truthful to ourselves. We are not truthful enough. That is why you see so many things we are seeing today. The governmental body, they are not truthful. The politicians, they are not truthful. Even the people campaigning for these people, they know quite all right. Osakwe no hodi know quite all right. That the condition of Benin is bad. Abadobaze know quite all right that the condition of Benin, that because there is no truth in them, that's why they support the same administration. Not that they don't know what they lack truth and honesty. If they must be honest to themselves, how will you be supporting the government? Look at when Edo State were created. I think Edo State is about 800 years ago, precisely. Look at when Edo State were created. Or let's take a vivid look at the 18th century, 1897, when the Britain or the Great British, they came to come and exile Volam and Ogbaisi to Calabar. Look at it. How did they find our palace? How did they find Benin? Benin was already having in all sin and shine. We were very good in trading palm oil, plantain, and some other things that can conglomerate some certain state. Why is it that we are still in this position today? I think it was recently the road that passed out of Obapala. When I visited Nigeria 2017, that place was bad. That place was bad. When I visited Nigeria, maybe Nana Dego don't tire. Why not let be truthful to ourselves that our government is bad and begin to fix it towards gradually? We must tell ourselves the truth. Without all telling ourselves the truth, it cannot work. Without you telling your leader or whatsoever. Even the first time I begin to see that witches are trying to say the truth, I say with my eye that witches say, this person, they're even in the coven world right now, they try to be truthful because they soak so many innocent blood. Why not you and I, who claim that what we not, who claim that we are good? Why not let that attitude be seen? All you are going to give me a lot of biblical latitude as we begin to say through the scripture one by one. We are nobody that doesn't read Bible in the church. Nobody tomorrow, right now, everybody is going to church. But how many of us in our leisure time we carry our Bible and we begin to see ourselves? Don't read the Bible for anybody. Read it for yourself. We have to be truthful to ourselves. That is why in the old field of advocacy, even the people that were making us right now, they don't even donate money. And here you are today, you are clapping. Who now do you directly talk to? A bomb war. Figure out some certain things. Create topic in it. Say, explain it gradually of what people have done wrong to you. It's hard time we begin to advance our color. Benin is one of the kingdoms in the world. We have two kingdoms in the world. The Great Britain and Benin Kingdom. How dare you use single-handedly a riffraff, a charlatan, a misguided element? You open that your dirty mouth. You cannot even control a sentence. Oh, we make banana do here do ma. Unu agbeluwa. I'm not stopping you from saying anything while you say. Figure out some certain things. Know that you have so bassy. Okay, won't we reap again? When you will be farming, you will plant yam. And the time for harvest will always come. Won't you? What I'm doing today, I'm going to harvest it. Nobody will harvest it for me. Neither will I want to harvest your own. He said, whatsoever. Whatsoever. Revelation 22 verse 12. He said, behold, I come quickly with a gift in my hand to give to everyone according to his works. Right now, let me tell you the two type of vessel. There are vessel unto honor, while there are vessel unto dishonor. If you want people to honor you on the last day, if you want to be recognized as Kwame Nkrumah of Ghana, then you will be recognized. If you want to be recognized as Dada of Okpobo, you will be recognized. If you want to be recognized as Kwinomina of Zaria, you will be recognized. If you want to be recognized, and if you want to be remembered as Idi Anigye Yesige Nkpobo, then you will be remembered. If you want to be remembered also as a Mota no Kawekoba, you will be remembered. If you want to be remembered as Oba Ovorame, who were betrayed by Oba Sekinile, you will be. In short, I've told us several times, why not leave down a good legacy? Leave it down. We find it difficult at times to come and watch the archbishop. By the grace of God, I'm an archbishop of activism. This is an area where lapses is. We don't want to hear the truth. He said, the truth you know, and you apply. He said, it will work for you. That's John 8:32. Let's say the truth to one another. Let's confess our sin what one to another. This is the only way we can be able. So if you are going to show love to people, he said, my dear children, 1 John 3:18. He said, my dear children, let us not love with words. Let us not love with words or speech, but with what action in truth. Let us be truthful at times with what we say. I'm not seeing anybody being against anybody. What they are trying to do is correction. Spare the rod, you spare the child. If you are traveling right now and you were given, maybe you are traveling to Africa, you are given 23 kilo and 23 kilo. Maybe some hairline, they can pardon you when you carry 25 and 25. Then we look at it, okay, Esa Viajando Africa, you say yes. You are traveling to Africa, you say yes. Okay, the 2 kilo, I dash you. Then maybe you are having your hand luggage, which is 10. If you are sensible enough, you don't need to wait. You just put it aside, okay, SS me, keep it at the manor. You keep it there. Then you tell your friend to hold all that too that's going to act as your paw. The people in Madrid that you do euro to euro, anytime I'm traveling at times my hand luggage will be 17 kilo. The way I will pack it, then I will be having another one that I'm going to be weighing 12 because I know the way to maneuver it, because I know that I'm going. So at the time your load became excess, they are going to charge you, particularly the bag you are to check in. If you meet bad head for counter, if you use 1 kilo take pass, you are going to pay for extra luggage. Some people's attitude today have become an extra luggage for them. Why not take away some? The one that is not relevant, take it out. Blunt it out. Leave it there. Pray for God. God, take it, this attitude away from me. This thing that is not making me. The book of Romans, he said, don't let your good be evil spoken of. The reason why today a lot of people, we are seeing what they've done, like the analogy I made before, you are giving me cap as a friend. You said, Comrade Newton, take this cap. Your name is written on it. And as an archbishop of activism, I gave you this cap as a friend. I gave you this cap as a brother. I gave you this cap as a co-comrade. I gave you this cap because we are being at the forefront together. We are one fair roll up our sleeve to make sure there's civilization and digitalization in our country. Then you give me cap as I'm putting it on and remove it. The old head is clip. I'm your friend. What about I'm your enemy? That is your good. I'll be evil spoken of. As you are doing good right now, pray God, don't let me use my hand to spoil the thing I've done well. That is what is happening to people today. You are a fighter, which we know. Nobody, any person that will doubt you, you are not a fighter. That person will beat that person. Any person that will say you are not work will beat that person. But most of the damages you have done is more than your work. You give people's cap at the end of the day, they put it on their head, your head is great. You are a pastor, you wed some couples. 2 days later, they divorce because your aunt did that woman go to marry her for night. You have not done any wedding. Don't let your good be evil spoken of. That is why today I slowly walk away. I don't want to begin to spoil all what I've done. If I'm coming out today as a do state government, I think a lot of people will be very happy. This is the kind of man that we need. Because I have no work they are going to question. I know what they are going to haunt. Rather than this boy have done this, he have done this. There's no professional humanity. There may be lapses in the life I live in the street there. This boy is this. This boy is that. But I don't have a jail sentence waiting for me. That's why Jesus Christ make it clear. He gave us a practical example. He gave us an exemplary life of himself. Even when a certain man met him, he said, "Perfect master, what will I do to enter into the kingdom of God?" He just told that person, "Please don't let Peter and John hear. Don't let Matthew hear about this. Who tell you nobody is perfect apart from my Father which is in heaven? Why are we claiming perfection? Nobody is telling you you must not be perfect. But the things and things you have done, I have the most bigger cassava. Is that the person who wants to come and rule us? You have made so many blunders, which we are correcting from here. We are correcting it from here. You have to change." He said, "Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand." What I'm doing right now, I'm doing good. So that you begin to watch some of the things you have done. Some of those life you have lived. If person called me, if there was a time, people were even complaining. A mother called me and he was telling me that. He said, "Comrade Newton, a lot of people, they are complaining. Say, the way you, they shout. They made them, they fear, you know, they let them watch your video. I was not imagining. Me, where they shout. Then, what? Don't you see now, I'm trying to cool my voice down because this is what they complained of. Or till a lady again confronted me. This face to face. Branuti, I love watching your program, but anytime you are just shouting, I'm afraid. I said, how? If people can complain of shouting and the teaching as is interesting, the Spirit of God is giving me more momentum to say those things which I'm dishing out, giving me more enthusiasm, but people still complain of it. What I need to do right now is to try and reduce the volume, if it is reducible. What we do right now, who is pursuing you who here? Who is pursuing who here? What we support is good governance. Good governance is what we wait for. If we check out your attitude, as one of those people right now, I think I'm, by the grace of God, I'm one of those people, Benin people, particularly majority of Benin people, those ones that are not senseless. They are looking onto us to cause hygiene in social media. Because my platform has been rated as one of the platforms that you will come. Ah, my dear, you must see something carry go out. By force, by fire. Because Benin people are looking unto me. And Benin people are looking unto me. Also, the Bible told me in New Testament, James chapter 4, verse 17. He said, "Though that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to them it become a sin. And I know how to say the truth. I'm a man of justice. I don't believe in equality. Equality is what I preach." Then I begin to see inequality in my world, in my area. I'm to speak about it. We must have a gene in our society. If what I'm saying right now is true, come and also read the verse that what I'm saying right now is bad. Come and tell me. I'm giving us an assignment. Don't just come and begin to make audio. We want to make sure there is sanity in this cyberspace. Don't just carry your phone because a word. I don't look at some people right now that is growing up. Talk. It's not going to make you go anywhere. You may have 100 viewers today, but how many of them will come again tomorrow? How many of them will use your word to fight some certain battles in their life? I have series of words today. I've studied it, and today those things are not part of me. If you read the book of 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 10, it says, "For whatsoever will love life and see good days must keep their tongue from evil and their lips from deceitful speech." He said, "For whosoever that love what is life." Whosoever, if you know you love your life and you want to see good days, you must keep what? Your tongue from evil. Don't speak evil against people. If you know tomorrow you are going to become an adulterer, if you know tomorrow you are going to involve in politics, mind what you say. Don't just come to social media and mention certain things, because even your word will be used again. Because we are not in time of social media. This is not the time of Oshoworo. No, this is not the time of Lucky Meredon. This is not the time of Oyegu. This is not the time of Abrusali. This is not the time of Iyenga. This is not the time of our late father, Ogbemudia. No, we are now in what? A new era. That what you say today will be used against you tomorrow. Do you know what promotes me today in our society? That boy go to his platform. Some of his messages are very powerful. Even when I want to advise you, it's from the Bible. If you know you want, you love life. If you know you want to live life, if the Bible is telling you in the book of 1 Peter, And for your information, if you come across Third Peter disappoints you. Wait for your Second Peter. I know a lot of people will be wondering. If you come across First Kings, and First Kings tell you, get out away from my way, you are a kabah. Wait for your Second Kings. Second Kings may favor you. And First Timothy came and he ate your money. Second Timothy will be your husband. That is the way life is. That is why if anybody chases you out today, that you are nobody, just ride on. Keep on. Don't give it up. Don't give up. Keep on. Keep the fire burning. Do not give up upon yourself. That dream. If you look at Joseph, that's why the problem I feel right now people have is that they don't study their Bible. They don't read history about people. Not only just come. People today now, you have been following one program for 2 years. What have you benefited apart from how to humiliate and lie on people? If I tell you ever since I set up this race for myself, I still burn midnight candle. But I'm not going for any exam. The people that are close to me know this. I read. It don't just come. It's not free. The word of God is free, but you need to buy Bible. The word of God is free. You need to buy Bible. So me talking to you like this, I paid more for it. I give up my time after working tirelessly in construction. Yeah, I move it down, eat snow, it didn't snow it down. It will kind of go and sleep. The people that are supporting the bad government today, if they are truthful to themselves, particularly my Benin brothers, if they will be truthful to themselves, they know that this is not the best way for government to treat its people. Rather than a school, they fall right now. I think two schools, I don't fall now for Nigeria. Where senator received millions of naira for just going there to go and fight. Not that they are fighting to make the country to be okay. They are just fighting themselves for irrelevant things. They don't even do what we have done for the world. But today, with our attitude, we have spoiled our work by ourselves. I don't know where most of the time, nobody is worrying anybody. At times, we are 99 problem to ourselves. Okay, now, a woman or a man that womanizes up and down or that manizes up and down, at the end of the day, you carry a fashion. Is there anybody worrying you? No, you are the one that go out there. Nobody came to your house to come and rape you. That's why most of the problem, most of the predicament we pass through today, it is we human beings that create it for ourselves. You have worked all day, labor all day. For example, right now, you are fixing the ties. You are being given a bedroom to fix. After fixing it, then you just carry with this machine with a tie. We call it Magina de Disco. Then you just what that take you a whole day to do? Just 1 second, just on machine. Just put on ground. You have finished the whole work with that. That's what a lot of people have done. It will labor all days. Fry Gary finish. Go marry fry another. Person know the name. Agbada. Agbada. Uya am Agbada. You just fry one Agbada. Uya go Eliza no mojoto. You spoil the Gary. Automatically, your mother or your father is going to be ahead of you. At time, we'll go to tap those days. You tired. After driving with barrow from Ogba River, you are coming to Eke. I'm talking about Ekewan Road. Ogba River that was there. After driving with barrow, instead of you to manage it home, then you come say you tired, hand they pain you. You already seen your house already. Then you carry 1 gallon with the heavy for inside. Now you pour and throw away. You've done that. That is, you haven't done yourself. We have to run this race and not get fainted. Just a little thing that would have made somebody to become an aspirant is spoiling just for one day. By the word comes out of his mouth. If you are a leader and somebody insulted you, are you think you are capable of leading such a person? That's why I talked about respect the other day. A lot of people be watching new things. Some people don't get sense. Particularly these followers.
The reason why Jesus Christ was having disciples was for a purpose. People have no sense. Ah, sir, this thing you are doing, don't be insulting your boss. He may get angry. This thing you are asking for, he may not give it to you. Oh, how the hell is that man? You insulting me, you want me, your child will just come to you. Instead of saying, ah, love is it, Baba. Good morning, Daddy. Ah, Daddy, you are looking good today. We'll say all manner of things first. And Daddy, the money I asked you the other time, I don't know if you can give me today or they need it today in school. Okay, your daddy will say, with the way you came and say love is it and all of all that. This Spanish Prince, I think I've given you a lot of grant to do whatever thing you want to do. Please don't make me vex. I saw your comment the last time, the way we were talking, but don't provoke the Spirit of God inside of me. Don't let me lay curse on you. And don't come to this platform and be fighting. Everybody have right to his or opinion. If you are being sent, but don't let me lay curse on you. You are one lay curse in one lay lower. Because the word I'm sharing right now is not my word, it's the word of God. I don't like distraction, smart prince. You better get your fucking head out of this place. I've known this name for quite some time now. I know the nonsense you performed the other time. And I don't want to see nuisance like you in this place. Otherwise, you are here, but not little way. Because you might be up on your way. I have not done anything wrong to you. If you have been sent here to start misbehaving, I'm going to put you in a state of resonancia magnetica. Please, just stay on your own. Everybody can create. That's why, if I'm watching people, there are a lot of people today that I watch. At times, if I like, I click it. I'm just to watch you. If I will have something to put to myself, don't come here and become a social nuisance. And these kind of people that are doing activities, they cannot make one sentence. Relevant people will not come and start insulting their comrades in the platform. Rather than they just comment, they encourage people. Hey, Uncle Victory, I see you vividly. Please, smart prince, I beg you in the name of God. They don't call you for here. You are not my follower, please. You are not my follower. And I don't want you to be one. Because I've seen the nonsense you perform here and there. I see you are supposed to even be at work at this time. Because nonsense. I don't want insulting people because the people have insulted. They want pray now. May God forgive them. Because you are insulting all the men. All walelewe. Because I have not done anything wrong to you. So you mind your damn business. We are talking about life. We have to be truthful to ourselves. If you are truthful enough, you should know where so many things that is happening today in our society. It's because the lack of truth that we are put forth that is making it to happen. May God help us in Jesus' name. If you also read the book of 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 12, it says, for the eye of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ear are attentive to their prayer. But the face of the Lord is against those who do evil. People like smart prince. He said, the eye of the Lord, God is always watching them. Anytime there is storm on the way, God will call them son. He will reveal it even before that time. Because the reason why we are doing this propaganda, even when somebody... Okay, thank you very much. That is the apostle of activism. God bless you, Comrade Dosa. I see you vividly. God bless you. Not that I just... Because anytime I see I take a closer to the comment, he's always coming here to come and be constituting news. Memantie, man, the people that are even needed in this platform are people no make any. Not those commenters who have been immune. Commenting, putting people into problem. I don't want you to praise me rather than go and study your book at home so that you do what people like Comrade Dosahon is doing, what people like other good comrades are doing, you know. So that's the best way. Because we were chatting, take it back. How will you say take it back yesterday? Today you are not taking it back again. Are you truthful in that nature? Tomorrow you support in the ideology. Today now you are not against the body that you belong to before. Up to now, I still believe in freedom. By one way or the other, there is a way I'm still fighting the fight of people freedom movement today. Because it is an ideology that my own is even modern. He has compromised his faith several times. He will be sincere to himself. But I've constantly condemned what I condemned before. I have constantly condemned what I condemned before. Hey, you're watching today. I don't see compromise my faith. That's why I believe in the ideology of taking back. What are they doing today right now? Where? was set up for all to use to fight this political immunism. The word they are criticizing today. That is to say, APC government is what we are not supporting. Please, let us be truthful to ourselves. As we do that, God will help us in Jesus' name. If you take a close look at the book of Psalm 112, verse 5, it says, good will come to those who are generous and lead freely, who conduct their affair with justice. Good will come to those who are generous and lead what freely, who conduct their affair with justice. All your affairs should be conducted with justice. In commenting, let your comment be justified. If you just come here right now, you can even tell me if I'm your enemy. If I'm doing well, tell me you are doing well. There is a sense why I see some people at times, when he does anything good, I'll say, this person I've done right. Even there was an argument I associate on during this very sack. I foreseen even before the stupid follower that is making audio today that this thing, there's something smelling before it finally smell around the social media. Then you say, go and think. You are following this person. What's supposed to be your duty? Is my duty to only fight in social media, or I should do some certain homework? Go on, very matter. Go and brush your teeth before you talk to me. There are a lot of people who are not supposed to be in this passable space. They are all here by mistake. Data verified message. You guys have no message. You make one audio. Let me see how eloquent it will be. You may bring out one suggestion on how our state can go forward. Or come and say the thing without you tagging it to anybody. I did not say today right now, though people are not truthful. There is no truth in the world according to Lucky Dube. There is no truth in this world. Not only Edo people. Do you know how many Spanish people betray themselves? If you so bossy to me today, you lie on me and my boss drove me out. One day somebody will also come and lie on you. Your boss will drove you out. It's all about reaping and sowing. And what is bad about that when you are reaping what you have sowed? If I choose today to buy open roof and go to Nigeria with some people, as in the campaign they go at the campaign follow on. It is what he has done to me. Don't say Edo people is bad, because what he done to me, I need to pay him back. It's not because of the Spirit of God. So let go and reason very well. And Lord, don't need the head news. I wonder these people serve. Good message, I know they carry. All these bloggers contributed to this in-win-win. We are seeing our state today. How will you have a pay? Do not the children yet unborn? What are they going to benefit from that? From those videos you guys are loading? What are they going to benefit? Most of the time, they don't carry my video. And I doesn't bloody care. Hey, what can I make him a blow? Oh, Saloba and Jodizoma. The book of Proverbs, he said, a man's own gift will make a way for him. He makes him sit among kings. I'm not doing what I'm doing because I want some refrat to watch me. No. I'm doing what I'm doing because, one, I know it is good for we as a nation to have this kind of a thing. You see, they promote, okay, now, oh, who are you? Oh, on IT, look on IT, now, where's that get one more? Good message, yeah, mo. They can never carry it. Because these people, they are not truthful. If you are truthful, you know that those messages are contaminated messages. They happily carry it. They want to build a nation. They are very happy carrying it. Why not carry some pastors when they preach? Cut it out. Put it there, imagine one more woman, so that people will also come and view some relevant topics from your page, rather than humiliation. Oh, go buy this, egbi. If you want more, man, go and look at that. It's out of social media. Eternal. A lot of people go to leave social media. Every day for, every salobo. He said, my word will not come back to me void. That is the word of God. That is why no word is to compare with the word of Newton, because this is the word of God. Before you can kill Newton, you have to first of all kill God, kill Jesus Christ, kill Holy Spirit. I dwell inside there. So the people that criticize me today, they are enemy of God. I'm not only rendering humanitarian. All what I've done in Italy, I know my contribution to the Italian people today. I know what I went through in Madrid, Spain. A lady there humiliated me. I will not say that online, but I bear the pains alone. They tell me so now. Brother Nat can testify. I started doing so many amendments. Brother Nat, if you are there, put if I'm wrong. All these are struggles. You that are making audio now from your call, what have you contributed? This is how you people clap, clap. You people were, very, very happy because you are enemy. If you are not truthful to me, you are my enemy. At the time you are following one person and you are not truthful to the person, and your truthfulness to the person would have made him to see the next level, God will punish you in a hurry. What are them, man? These are the problems a lot of people have created. Must you clap for everything? Your son is just 18 years because you are not truthful to you. He's just 15 years because you are not truthful to yourself. Who you are Ben Samu Yobo? What fear? These are the problems we have today. We clap. Must you clap? The Bible says, say, who God loved, he changed time. What he changed in this. Oh, Salopana love, what discipline way. That is to say, everybody that comes to social media today to run some correction, they are not only humiliating you, they are telling you, if you need me, warrior, if from that day, 2-3 videos you done, it changes it all, you will see that they will call for ceasefire. Oh, man, know that people are watching you to change because of the potential you show to them from the very first. Okay, let's assume now I change my program. Do you know how many people is going to call me and say, you know, I have a lot of mothers, I have a lot of fathers. I made them coach by myself. Don't be a fan to me. Tell me the truth. That's why my platform is International Association for the Advancement of Colored People hashtag equality. I never wanted to introduce myself as a president. Add any of them the platform. I don't need them. Because you have the same right with me. At the time I begin to see myself in a higher esteem, there are things you are supposed to tell me, you don't tell me again. Then me and you, just the way some people is right now. Hey, carry on. I get cassava, carry on. Umwogebana, carry on. I humiliate on, carry on. Today, now, this is the day of reckoning. We are beseeching you, brethren, that you change away from all those things and turn it what? A new leaf. If you turn a new leaf, do you know how many people is going to stand up and say, well, this thing must be done like this. Right now, this person has changed. We need to see the changes. We don't want fake changes. We don't want it. What we want is the real change. May God help us in Jesus' name. Then, if you read the book of Ephesians chapter 4, verse 1, then Paul the Apostle, there was something Paul the Apostle said that I love so much. Anytime I remember it, it's something always, something good always coming to my heart. You know what he said? He said, I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you that ye walk worthy of the vocation wherewith you are called. Paul, we are not in prison. Paul, we are not in Oko. Do you know what happened to Paul? The thing that Paul used to do, he can no longer do it again. A man humiliate. He can no longer humiliate again. When he go just see fingers, Paul go not see fingers. Paul, I'm talking about Paul the Apostle in the Bible. He said, the prisoner of the Lord. Paul, we are not in prison because there was that restriction because of the changes that he had found in Christ. If you change, you change. And there is a sense right now, I will say, new annuity, the prisoner of advocacy, because there are things I cannot say. Eh, we been so. Oh, man, not going to social media. Oh, wow, guana. He not going to war level. Ni war law anyway. He combine anointing and annoyance together. I combine anointing and annoyance together. He tell me any man way. My dear Ule. But because right now I'm not a prisoner of advocacy, there are things I can no longer say because he atababan or diakeme vodao. I may want to be given contract as a builder. Yeah, why son? Somebody will just call the managing director of the company. I heard that the International Association, that guy, Comrade Newton, aka the Archbishop of Activism, is soliciting contract from you that worth 10 billion. Don't give him that contract. We don't have a proof right now. That guy is a snake. He's a green snake. I will lose the contract. Why? Because of my attitude of before. We are affecting now my future. Why not change? Why not change? This was what the apostle that I could feel it that you see some fathers today right now did they grow old? Oh wait, maybe my way not so wanna. A day came, my friend, he may be watching right now, his father called up, or when why or when there was a day. Ian is a moho moho moho. Then when I toast the spirit in Upasia, he said, our head that they don't reach out. He tried to tell us where what you wire. My late father, blessed memory, went further to explain again. Oh, we may make an idea deep book when I'm miserable. When you die to say, no, why you know, why we went away? A truthful father. That is it. So we should be very, very careful. Or we are walking, see, I can learn no why you see. A guy that is gradually doing his activism know that he's going somewhere. That's why some people today, right now, some of our Benin brothers, we know them very well. I will not say we're Benin boys, Benin men, not good. No, that is not right. Don't group everybody. Figure out one part. We know the people that is supporting APC in Nigeria, APC in Edo State, Abatobaze and Osakwono Holding. They are the ones that particularly Osakwono Holding inside. You go carry road. We don't work for any. He does not understand that truthfulness is the credo of a modern development in the country. Truthfulness. That's what you are going to hold if your state must go forward. If he uses the knowledge that he has knowledge, but he doesn't have wisdom. That is what he lacks. Send the video to Osakwono Holding. He lack wisdom. And it's God that gives wisdom. All he was able to do, acquire syndrome. He was able to go to school, learn all grammar, cram it, come to social media. He cannot even rush the way I rush. He does not have one single word of God in him. That is why today, it's still in a dose. Hey, squeeze the bomber. Osakwono Holding, you are the great meal. We don't have government now. Me and you, we are going to be having a Sabbath space problem. My way, I have a Sabbath space problem for it. Oh, what to act, baby, don't Ogu wa tuagbe. Let me show us, for those of us that have not seen it. All these are stupidity to the highest order. Stupidity to the highest order. Because of what you are going to eat. If you want to be truthful to yourself, you know that the government, they are not trying. You know quite all right. You know the money that we have, that they are not using it very well. How dare you be supporting one useless government? If you dare me, if you make come away, no yave, or I'll give you the serial number. No yave, we imagine the life away. Because I want to keep quiet and watch some people have a rethink in their mind. Do you know how many of our mothers today who got nothing to eat? We are talking to the government. Why do I back my way? Someone may choose to compromise his integrity. I don't compromise my integrity. What I stand for today is what I'm standing for tomorrow. That is me. We need good governance. We need it. It's all take it back all the way. So worry or not so worry. I've told that way several times with that number. Let me show it to us. It's good today, Nyama. It's good today, Nyama. What's happening? What is it? We're mad at Goni. New Year time of Baseki. It's good, Nyama. You do not see that one. All you could do, you're away the entire your condition. When they bring me home, I know you have been speaking English, but there's yeah one knocky way out. Yeah one knocky. Most of the boy away at boy. A babon away at boy. Tear your tone. Nonsense. Well, how wicked will people will be? How wicked? Do they want to know why? Do they want to know why? What so one or but you are a kill him in the book of Genesis chapter 4. A kill him. This is ISO program because of what you are going to eat.
Good. According to eyewitnesses,
look at it.
Osamudia Stephen arrived school as early as 7:30 a.m. but was not as fortunate as the other children, as a part of the building, which roof was removed to pave way for innovation, collapsed on him, killing him in the process.
By that time, people, they work here.
Now, this is a school. This is a school. We have government. People are paying taxes. Then a good social media presenter, this one should touch you if you get to be my family friend or if you get to be my child. Whatsoever I must saw it. For those of you that are so bad at TVs today, Oko Wawodao. I would, in this modern world, in this modern world, we will still have this kind of a school. Yeah, in this modern world, we go here no lie though.
come this side.
Vigo ya no like though.
As I come, come la, come sit. Ah, na small pikin. Nine four so.
We people say maybe na, maybe girl in your thirty where they happen. We don't know say na this a building. Nine four for one of the students body for here. So as we see na they come rescue her. You are a where we people probably say the student, all of them sit down, the teachers, all of them sit down, all of them pack their motor here. Okay, as they rescue the boy, come out. They drop before for ordinary grant. With that pretty man as a mother, they don't feel rescue the boy, go hospital.
Oh, that's the
Now APC they be. All these are APC gang. Because APC mission have told us a time without number is the book of John 10:10. They come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Because ASK. So that we may have life and have it in abundance. But we don't embrace them. This is what you see. If you investigate the papa, maybe in a PDP or APC, Buhari now vote for. I told you, let mind the way we support bad government. I was able to convince and talk to a lot of people. Instead of you to go vote for APC, go vote for government where going to keep people. Sit down in your house. The people that couldn't localize or locate say where there be one vote, so were a ballot box not there. I call all of them, stay at home. Don't cast that vote to anything because you are solely killing. And one day, if you don't happen to you, it will happen to your children. Let's be very, very careful over the administration with something. This is the word of God for everyone. See, in this modern life, Anna ye me school, ye school ye nyaga nyaga. Osa kwe no kwe beside. Why you not control that one? Why you not control that one? Okay, school, where were you? The little education you are able to acquire now. Good English, where you acquire. And only the way I tell you, he don't even set economy. There are people right now who is more even eloquent than you. They are beggars here in Europe. What? He am not going to be there. They are all hooligan. A vagabond and Australia wallaby. You see, they're not back. At least, even over Sununa. You are supposed to make video to it. Maybe you don't do, I don't know. If you don't do, I God forgive you. If you never do video concerning this child now, where Yahweh? Where Yahweh? Because it's part of your work. If you can show road and you don't show this boy that was collapsed, that beauty collapsed upon, my dear, you will have the wrath of the Lord soonest. O Saloboa no wa soonest. It's instead of them to go to school and acquire better things. No wonder there was a sin in the book of Hosea chapter 4 verse 6. He said, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. They doesn't have knowledge about good government. That's why they talk anyhow like that. Any person that got the knowledge of God, that got the knowledge of government, of good government in his head, you will not support this administration. Who support it? You will not mistakenly even support it. Okay, me that is talking right now, your life is not better than as I do. It will not go in. I'll show you some shit. You will work for 2 months to get the money. Oh, that was a real humiliation in here. You know what? It's not affecting me in any form. But there are these kind of people what we are speaking for. What is the government doing with our money? Let's be truthful to ourselves. Let's be truthful to ourselves. A you that just growing up, you are not, maybe you should be at your maybe you we are say 40 now, or you day your early 40. You don't even have a gene in your land. Right now, if you watch it right now, I treat different kind of topics. You come and create one topic. We don't teach a topic up and let us have point in it. That I mean go as a boy. We don't we body your why. We don't we your why. Maybe the grammar I won't have, or we have, or I'm have a soul. Do you know what state of Halloween? When the state of Halloween there? It's an ugly state. A state of Halloween is what you guys have put at those state right now. All those political vampires. Because of what we are going to eat. Why not go around and submit those pictures? Our government, please, government, look at area you need to work on right now. The student or the people, their school is very bad. You don't see anybody that do that. Or the support is evil because of the food you are going to eat. And me, you guys, right now, anytime you come and una the best show boy, who believe in Yahweh? Me, I not be terrorist, I not be anything. But unumene away boy, he attack now. Go and do your investigation. Nonsense, a nikompu. Have idiot, you know, mama. You don't even have a gene in your life. What you have, what you give. He showed that. Hey, who were man? This one showed that all of you men are wicked. Full and yes, men. That one now become a daily routine. Because that one that has now become a natural sin on me. It has become a natural endowment. We have endorsed the killing of full and yes, men. But I felt very bad when I saw this video. That the building collapsing upon a child. Benu wa koko si eveye e family na gbe o salobo ani mega o salobo an o jagbon je mi o kan be si eveye ju gbagbe be ni Jesu as you people keep on embezzling the dose treasury and wire bo wa be Dubai ah that house we corrode upon you people in Jesus name because Emmanuel monowulo Emmanuel let be truthful to ourselves for once. Let every one of us be truthful for ourselves for once. Emmanuel Monogulo, Emmanuel Mane Fulani S. Megbeleni, Emmanuel Emmanuel Megbe, Emmanuel Mane Hemia Megbe. If you have ever wanted an area, you can wait Bogue. And that thing, the way no one even have a mion, a government have a way of assisting the person or unemployed benefit that somebody have used it to honor a barrier you wear. What a bomb man could do. But we might see what the government wear, my dear. I want to see your response first. May God Almighty help us in Jesus' name. These are the problem. No, there's no truth in the world. The government is not truthful. The people we are even expecting, okay, they will be truthful. They sold themselves to the devil. Since you guys right now vote for Muhammadu Buhari, what have been your gain? What have you benefited? What have you benefited? He said, the thief cometh not, but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. The book of John 10:10. He said, I, the Lord, have come so that you may have life and have it in abundance. That is why this message is coming up today. All my claims is from the Bible. I have no words of my own. It is the word of God. And he has given me the grace so that I should also go out there and preach it to people. If you read the book of Ephesians chapter 4, verse 5, he said, one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. That is to say, if we are truthful to ourselves, we know that it is one Lord, it is one faith, and it is one baptism. Let create this mind of truthfulness. If the government is bad, let us know it's bad. On my way, don't be it did not stop you from the government giving you what it's supposed to give you. Let us say the truth. How can we agripo boy? Where do you show up? Or base kibi upo na? Do you know how many kilometers? Oibo the road is no longer a problem in anywhere. Road is no longer a problem. It's not a problem in Niger. It's not a problem in Morocco. See in Nigeria there. Because it greet Taiwan road. It's our right. We are supposed to have road. We are supposed to have road. We are supposed to have a hospital, is our right. Unemployed benefit. If not that one with the drag now, huh? Okay, we never boy in a trick. See yet no good road. Building fall upon a people in a school. That's the worst government we have ever seen. But yet, they have assets in Dubai. Their children are living a luxurious life. You that is campaigning for them. Let their children start speaking for them that my father is trying. Let their children, if their children will be so bold enough. Let them come and speak for them in the telly or anywhere that my father is trying. If their father is doing well, won't their children come out and praise their father's work or their wife? Let them come and praise for them. All they do, they always want to tell lies. To get something from the European. That was why Obama came to Italy and signed bilateral agreement. For you to be deported. You that are insulting me today. Who conspired against me. For you guys to be deported. You are not going to be deported. You are not going to my person may not be reading Nigerian, but already vivant. Why? Now you know. I can choose to stay here all the days of my life. I work here up to now. I'm still working. Email you are a person everywhere. Are you so a person in your state? You are already in the state of Halloween already. Blackout all true. Nonsense. You don't even have a gene in your life. Then here we are. We are supporting. We are very happy supporting bad government benevolently. Let's put for that by the grace of God before we call it a day. If you read the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 21, it says, "For we are taking pains to do what is right. It is painful at times to do what is right. Not only in the eyes of the Lord, but also in the eyes of men." Let this particular verb be at the center of your head. 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 21. He said, "For we are taking pains to do what is right." That is what I take today. I have to study. I have to burn me in a candle to make sure that I come with messages that can catapult us from the realm where we are right now to the realm where in the play Mamako to the glory of God. He said, not only in the eyes of the Lord, but also in the eyes of men. I told her, that's why I told her from the beginning that the importance of the people that babat you or gossip you is to let you know where human way here now, tango ne yahweh. They all get up, most of all, for not they wear clothes. I wear he, that guy, every milk my way, y'all. If you want to live a life at times that pleases you, you will be having problems. At times, everywhere you know you send. Why you the other clothes for Nigeria native? Why you know they wear another pant go party if you not send? You send it. Why you might have told you? But you know the look people go the way you are decoin. You buy and pay. That is the difference there. May God help us in Jesus' name. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 5. He said, "Do your best to present yourself to God as one approved, a workman who does not need to be ashamed and correctly handle the word of truth." We should be truthful in anything we are doing. Are you campaigning for the government? Be truthful. Let us be frank and sincere to ourselves. We are right now in a state of political jeopardy. In this state, we are supposed to be. Ask yourself this question. You that is watching me right now, is it where we are right now? Is that where we are supposed to be? We need to be sincere to ourselves. Because on a very good day, the grave will be corroded. We need to be sincere to ourselves. Let's be sincere to ourselves. Is this one a government? Are we under a democracy or a demonstration of grace? Are you not seeing Holocaust? Like what happened in Germany 1945? Are you not seeing killing of the Christians like you and I who believe in the resurrection power of Jesus Christ? Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing that the competency of the past administration, they are repeating it again? Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing the book of John 10:10? I just quoted to you right now, not quite long ago, that the thief cometh not to kill, to steal, and to destroy. Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing it that our government have no evidential value for humanity? If they have, why will such school not be reported by now to Federal Ministry of Education that school need to be abandoned? Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing Osakweno Kwemila is not doing what is right, Benin? Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing that we have political vampires and political terrorists and political inwizi that God is going to punish them in a hurry? Are you not seeing it? Are you not tired of living this kind of life? Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing it that we are not experiencing good government? Are you not seeing it that what of environment left behind? What Britain stole? They have not returned it. Have you not seen it? Are you not seeing it that Britain is living with our resources which they stole in 1895, 97? Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing that we are in a foreign land suffering? Are you not seeing it? The eyes have seen, the ears have heard. What else do you want to hear? And what sign do you want to see again? For you to know that this government, they are incompetent of ruling this very country. Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing it that by now we are supposed to roll our sleeve and be at the center dinner table of human civilization, but not as a waiter, but as a diner, not even as a food to be eaten, but as the person that go to eat the food? Are you not seeing it that we are supposed to be at the forefront of human civilization today? Are you not seeing that Nigerians don't have evidential value for humanity? Are you not seeing that fool and enhancement have made grave to be corroded upon our innocent brothers and sisters? Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing it that today our fathers, our mother can no longer close their eyes in some of the neighboring village? Are you not seeing it? What have you not seen? Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing it that the youth, they are killing themselves with cutting here and there? Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing that the commissioner of police or the forces, they are not making the necessary implementation to stop cutting? Are you not seeing that the cutting that we are seeing today is being sponsored by the government? If not, they must have promulgated a law that will stop our youth from killing themselves. Are you not seeing that the sheen and shine of Edo State have been lost some time ago? Are you not seeing that AAC have come so that we may have life and have it in abundance? Are you not seeing the house so whatever will be betrayed? Are you not seeing how people right now, they are trying to humiliate that man? Are you not seeing that there's no truth in this world, as Lord Dube sang in one of his albums? Are you not seeing it? What have you not seen? What have you not seen? Are you not seeing it that the minimum wage that we have in Nigeria is just about $40, be 40 euros? Are you not seeing it? That cannot even fill a tank here in Europe. Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing that the election that was had recently was not free and fair? Are you not seeing that INEC became a governmental body, not a private body? Are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing that no road is still good in Benin? Are you not seeing that people are still living in darkness? Are you not seeing that so many lives are being taken unknowingly? Are you not seeing that there is ritualism everywhere? Are you not seeing the most fattest industry right now is ritualism in Nigeria? Are you not seeing? What have you not seen? Are you not seeing it? Don't let us be blind away from the truth. The truth, you know, will set you free. John 8:32. He said, and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. What is going to free us from this very bondage? What is going to free us from these perpetual pains that we are going through today is for us to tell each other the truth. If all to tell each other the truth, without that, it cannot work. Are you not seeing that the solid churches is the most fastest growing entrepreneurship in Nigeria? Precisely Africa as a whole, are you not seeing it? Are you not seeing that the money that the country where pastors are flying private jet and they have not set up one church in Syria, they have not set up one church in Iran, and they have not gone to Afghanistan for a crusade. They don't even have a single church in North Korea, in any of these places that have fought war. Are you not seeing that we are not living the way we are supposed to be? Are you not seeing that Pentecostal have been turned to Pentirasta? Are you not seeing that our state is in a state of inwinwins? Look at where we are. You not seeing it today? Are you not seeing that there's no truth in the world? What have you not seen? Are we not seeing it? What other sign do we need? Are you not seeing that there was a sense why Thomas asked Jesus Christ, I want to see that hand before I believe that you were killed. You were really the one that was killed and the third day you resurrected and you were nailed on the cross. I want to see the hand. What proving have they given to us that they are good government? Are you not seeing that this government is not going to lead to Nigeria to anywhere? Are you not seeing that people right now, they are dying of hunger and starvation? Do you know how much Nigerian worth if we really want to manage the economy? But the person that God sent was a more or less worry, but we didn't appreciate him. Who talked about difference between living wage and a minimum wage? We tend to make sure that minimum wage right now will now be 100,000. People did not want it. They want to die. What other sign do we want? What other thing do we want to see? May God help us all in Jesus' name. Colossians 3:9 says, do not lie to each other, since you have taken off your old self with its practice. Do not lie to each other. Let us stop deceiving ourselves. Politicians, let us stop, because Agbona Emuerie, man. Agbona Emuerie is only one life. It's only one life. After that, the judgment. If the Bible says, what shall it profit a man to gain the whole world and suffer the loss of his own soul? What shall a man give in an exchange for eternal life? Certainly nothing. Ephesians 4:25. Therefore, each of you must put off falsehood and speak truthfully to your neighbor. We are all members of one body. Let's take away all this falsehood. Let's begin to speak truthfully to one another. Condemn it. The government, please, this is what we are supposed to do. If you look at the nonsense in social media today, I don't blame people who are the analyzer right now. They are analyzing what you have done. then you go and watch it in any of those areas you might have done well. Go and check your comment. If your comment is in the line with what the person is saying, go and check the comment, what you are commenting. If the comment you are commenting to that program, if the comment you are commenting to your boss, if the comment you are commenting to your madam, whether it's really on in line with what the person is saying, or whether the person worth blessing love for, you are telling the person, go on, humiliate them, lie on them. The same punishment that is coming to the person will one day get to you if you refuse to repent, because we are here to come and preach the word of God to you, so that you will change and your life will be transformed. If you read the book of Matthew chapter 5 verse 8, it says, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. If your heart is pure, you will see God, people like us. Because whatever thing we are doing, I'm not expecting you to tell me thank you, return. Rather than I've saved my own, I'm gone. That's why today I'm the most happiest person. If your way praise the Lord, it will make your enemy to be at peace with you. That's the thing that God does. God help us in Jesus' name. And if you take vividly look, take a biblical attitude and go to the book of Proverbs chapter 14 verse 5. It says, an honest weakness does not deceive, but a false weakness pour out what lies. An honest weakness. Right now, I'm witnessing unto you, telling you about the things, plans that God have for us. We have talked about the wickedness of some people. We have treated so many topics here. Just follow us on our YouTube, IACP TV. Follow, then you begin to go through our message. You will understand where we are coming from. It's all about good governance. I don't have personal issue with anybody, but I will have personal issue with you when, if they do road, you show it. But when calamity is happening as a result of the negligency of the government, this one is not what they say. There was one that happened. I think there was one that was in Arosa. The school was not having roof. It was leaking water. But today people can steal our money and go and build whatever house they want to build. Not a decent time, that house will fall down. Just as that school fell, as a result of our bad government, the money you would have used to build our school, then you steal the money and keep it for yourself. This is a prayer. Whatsoever a man saw, Galatians, he talked about it. He said, don't be deceived. Our God is not more. Whatsoever our government have sold, any of these souls that are dying under the administration, any of this life that are dead under the administration, they are going to be held accountable. It's not only the pastor that are going to be accountable for it. During your tenure, how many people died? About 1,000 people died during your tenure. How did they die? Because of your negligence, because of your incompetency, because you make yourself to become instrument of radical and caricature, the state government money, then you use it to go and lodge with women in Dubai. You go to fiesta for women, carry different women in university. Those women will give you HIV AIDS one day in Jesus' name. As you keep on. Repair our society. The money is there. We have the money. If we doesn't have the money, let them come and say how much they are receiving as a salary. And the way your charge is precious to you right now is in California. Your charge is precious to you right now is in Chicago. Your charge is precious to you right now is in New York. Some of them are in Washington. Some of them are in Dubai, going to school. Also, when of your bad doba, your very doving. As your child are dear to you, so that child that just died is dear also to their parent. That child may become president tomorrow. You shorten their life because not that that child want to die. Go and look at the world that fall. Not be able to happen. Anything that happen in Europe here, it's not the negligence of the government. It's because it's a natural disaster. That is not a natural disaster. I'm aware. A government not supposed to get what where they protect wing. No. This as a result of the negligences of the government. Somebody will still come and show one road. Look at the road they tied yesterday. What bitered you? It pours on your head. You are an Australian wallaby. Nonsense. Nikompo. If you read the book of John chapter 4 verse 24, it says God is a spirit, and those who must worship him or worship him in spirit and in truth. If you look back, most of the verses I'm quoting to you right now, most of them, truth is this. I die to say there is a sense why we must have to tell ourselves the truth. And so we'll come and we are. And for you to tell your friend at times that it's still smelling, just look at it. There's a clothes. There's one new clothes up. I just bought. My doctor prescribed it for me. There are people that don't know the way to tell their friend that they have a mouth odor. The best way to say it up, you saying, but your teeth, they smell, may give you slap or you may not pray again forever. But there are way people, mature people like us, by the grace of God, will tell you, there is one McLean I'm using now. They say now 48 and a doctor you have prescribed and give me. You will give them. He said now 3 times they use them a week. By so doing, you have corrected that friend that have mouth odor. You find out that your friend he has a body odor. Just say there's one deodorant right now I'm using. It was my uncle that sent it from Bamako in Mali. It's very good. And Peral is the nearest supermarket. Just say that. Just take this one. Try them. You they use them 3 times in a day. You know they sweat again. Automatically you are helping that friend to kill what that body odor. A lot of people will start mocking you up and down. Mommy, or we are. Have you been able to cause that correction? That's what we are seeing today in social media. They clap for everything. It's killing other people's children, you are clapping. It's humiliating people, you are clapping. He's talking about how he slept with a girl, you are clapping. Senseless. A woman. The book of James chapter 5, verse 16, it says, confess your fault one to another. It is lawful that you confess your fault one to another and pray for one another, but ye may heal. And he did the effectual prayer of the righteous. He said, he availeth what much. This is the word of God. This is not my word. James chapter 5, verse 16. He said, confess your fault. You can confess your fault to this person. Tell the person you are going wrong. That is his fault. Let's confess it to one another. That's the best way we can have a better society. Know that a lot of people will call right now because you want to make me happy. You call into my program. Even when I'm doing bad. The area I'm doing good, talk about it. Don't talk about the area there are lapses. These are where problem lies. May God Almighty help us in Jesus' name. If you read the book of Galatians chapter 4 verse 16, he said, I therefore became your enemy because I tell you the truth. Very interesting verse of the Bible. Let's take this one as a memory verse. Galatians 4 verse 10. He said, I therefore became your enemy because I tell you the truth. Today, I'm most people's enemy because I preach the word of truth. I ain't too surprised about that. God will deliver and help us all in Jesus' name. By the grace of God, the reason why I still keep on encouraging myself to come out with teaching like this because he's helping a lot of people. A lot of people, they are imitating by reading their Bible and all of that. That's why anybody that wants to fight me, you are fighting God. Because I'm going to reply you with the word of God. That is it. He said the word of God returned toward the righteous. They runneth into it and they are saved. If you read the book of Proverbs 23 verse 23, he said, buy the truth and sell it not. And also wisdom and instruction and understanding. He said, buy the truth. You use your money to buy Bible, but the miracle that is going to be happening, the signs and wonders, don't sell it. That is why today we don't collect online offering. Even as I'm dishing out the world right now, most of all that are going to be going to church tomorrow. You have attended your service today. You are always going to go to church and say, God, I thank you for making me to be alive. Because most people, most pastors, what they do, they don't teach like this. All what they do, Mary, Jesus Christ, we are going. Where was he going? They read it to you. All you do, you re-echo it again. At the end of the day, you share the grace and go on. We need to teach ourselves. Just the way I'm teaching right now, I'm teaching myself. Proverbs 23:23. He said, buy the truth and sell it not. Buy Bible, don't sell out the word of God. You bring out a verse during December, come and sow into this verse. You are selling it. You are selling it. God Almighty will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. I say, Ancient of Glory will help us in that matter. Let's really look at some reason we must have to be truthful. We must be truthful in love. The Bible is urging us that we must be truthful in love. If you read the book of Ephesians chapter 4 verse 15, it says, but speaking this truth in love may grow up into him all things which are in head, even Christ. We must have to speak the truth in love. If you want to tell anybody the truth, tell the person in love. That's why they say truth is bitter, but say it. If the person happens to manage the bitterness, imagine somebody complain that I shout to my because that one is afraid to watch my program, and that is true. And if you watch it today right now, I'm talking with calmness. May God help us in Jesus' name. Another thing we must need to do, we must be truthful because we are new creatures in Christ. We must have to be truthful because that old Adamic nature, is already being sacrificed for. A human sacrifice was made. That was Jesus Christ. God sent in the book of John 3:16, say, for God so loved the world. He sent his only begotten son, something begotten that something he cherished most, something he liked most, to come and die for you and I. What are you giving today in reciprocating the life that God have given to you so that to enable to break up the wall of hostility, that wall that was causing demarcation when the first Adam lost the glory? God knows that we are no longer having a constant communion with him again. The best way he can win us by was to send his only begotten son. A human sacrifice we have made. If you carry it to our traditional level of life, if you look at it, then who have been in this way, how we also sacrifice ourselves for all by work, but for the palace to be restored. So there have been restoration. Somebody must pay the price. If you look at it today, Omoye Lesowore come all the way from America so that to come and join us to take back our country. But at the end of the day, it did not work. Let us not kill ourselves. Let us not begin to humiliate ourselves. It's all about sacrifice. The sacrifice you have made, God will reward you. Jesus Christ did not say, God, I've killed myself for the people. Why did you leave me? But there was a time when the pain were increasing. The pain became much. He looked at it. He said, Father, I hope this cup will pass me by. He said, but not my will. Let your will be done. He quickly corrected that statement because he know that this is a thing I've come for. I have to glorify God first before God will glorify my name. How does God respect Jesus? He said he gave him a name that is above every other name. The mention of that name, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. That is the benefit you get when you make sacrifice with love. When you sacrifice in truthfulness, these are things your name will be. If you look at Nelson Mandela today, because he sacrificed with truthfulness, today Nelson Mandela, he blossom everywhere. If you look at Kwame Nkrumah of Ghana, if you look at it today, his name is everywhere. If you look at Idi Amin Yesige today, his name is everywhere. If you look at Martin Luther King, his name is everywhere. If you look at my name right now, I'm still growing up by the grace of God with your prayer. We will get to the mountain top. He is everywhere. That boy, I love his word. That boy, I love what he's doing. That boy, I like the way he quotes the Bible. That boy, I want to be like him. How many, in what area have you buttressed good behavior that people want to emulate you today? What do people say about you? Are people want to ever use your word to correct on certain impression, or they also use it to humiliate people? What seed are you leaving behind? Is a question that we must ask ourselves. We must be truthful because we are now new creature in Christ. Ephesians 4:22, he said, we are taught with regard to your former way of life, to put off your old self, which is being corrupted by its deceitful desire. That former way that is fraudulent, that former way that is full of sin, that former way that's full of you talking anyhow, you have to put it out. Right now, you are embarking on a new race. What people is expected to see from you is a spirit of a leadership. You now have shock observer. O sa yon moro, wien ton sisi mou yon te agbe mi, o wien vege mou yon ave mou sisi yon to o moda men, o wien tangba da mou yon te abi o man, o wien vege, o wien ave mou agba da yon to. These are the things right now that's supposed to be our new attitude. That is repentance. That is a genuine repentance. That's a genuine repentance. Pass this message across to everyone. If you know you are vying for any position, your past life have nothing to write home about, you can still amend it. You can see amend it. Blunt out the old you. But if you look the book of Romans chapter 6 verse 6, it says, for we know that our old self were crucified. Our old self, that Adamic nature, were crucified along with him in the cross. Eve, deceiving Adam, were crucified along the cross. That war of hostility were crucified along the cross. That demarcation were crucified along the cross. That barrier were crucified along the cross. That hatred were crucified along the cross. Backbiting, bitterness. BB that now become an international Babele. BB is also considerable, but at the time become IBB, international Babele. That is to say, he have Babele for you in everywhere. If he just honored BB, just one locality, at the time he become IBB, international Babele, then you are finished. Good. Jesus Christ also paid for it in the cross of Christ. That was why he said it is finished. Babele is finished. hate us. We are not supposed to hate us, rather that to walk in love, in humility, in peace, in long suffering, forbearing what one another. That is the thing we are supposed to do. Crucify with sin so that the body ruled by sin might be done away with. That you should no longer be slave to sin. We are no longer supposed to be slave to those things that we used, that used to draw us behind. Every of those mistakes you might have done, there's time for you to amend it. As I'm talking to you right now, watching me, I'm talking to myself. You have lied on people. A lot of people have been driven away from war. You have caused a lot of chaos that scattered a family. You can still call the family and reunite the family. There are so many things you have done. A lot of people have laid curse on you because of what you have done. There was a message that I preached one time, which I'm going to repeat it again. Don't open door for the devil. Do not open door for the devil. We must be truthful because we are member of the same body. That's why Ephesians chapter 4 verse 5 said, it's a one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. We are member. Okay, who are we fighting ourselves? Why do we always constantly use this word, though, people? Any no we do we here. How is your character? Who knows so well, we're not going to do it. We're saying that we're not the woman we're saying. It is because they speak against you, because there are so many lapses in the good that you are doing. Don't let your good be evil spoken of. In the book of Romans, don't let your... Be very, very careful. He said, guard your heart with all diligence, because out of it lies the issues of life. If you watch it today right now, I right from time, my advocacy have been to counterpunch. My advocacy have been not to humiliate anybody. My advocacy is all about telling you that this thing you have sold, you have to rip it out. You have to blunt it out. That have been my advocacy. May God Almighty help us all in Jesus' name. Let us be drawing the curtain close here. By the grace of God, I think we are able to finish up the topic. We are going to be seeing next Saturday by the grace of God. Please like our page and share our video if you want. If you know you are freedom on your own, you are not. That is subjection of the devil. Share our video. No matter what, as you are sharing it, you are also fulfilling the scripture, going to all the world and preach the gospel to every living creature. And I know most people have been warned. A lot of people were humiliated for sharing my video. A lot of people does not know the reason why at times I'm hungry. I think I'm the most God-fearing person. If really the way I was treated, I really once started to what I know I want to tell you to humiliate people. I can kill someone's political career, not by verbal talk, but with your character. I'll preach it out from the Bible. I will do protest on your attitude. And this is the thing that the area people are seeing it that maybe you are good, I will bring it out and you are done. But I choose not to do it because I don't stand against anybody where I see you are. So that when I'm drawing my way, if you stand, you will die in a hurry. If you tempt me by just like that, by mistake, you will die by correction. That's why people today, there are people that are dead spiritually already. They are just like a walking corpse. Nothing is remaining with them. There are a lot of people like that. You just see them. They say, empty vessel make the largest noise. Please, as a follower, let's be truthful. Stand for the truth. Stand for justice. As you do that, God will bless you all in Jesus' name. By the grace of God, I've got delivered. We are going to be seeing again next Saturday. Next Saturday as we prepare ahead in Jesus' name. And right now, we are seeing the era of taking back our nation. So at the time, the people that cast up this recent vote, I want them to, they will realize their mistake. That is why I hardly talk about Fula, clean of Fula and enhancement right now. Because the same people that you are feeling for, they don't feel for themselves. So let's enjoy the piece of music. God bless you all in Jesus' name. Just have a wonderful weekend. God bless you all. God bless you. God bless you. Please share this video. Share this video. And don't fail to follow us on our YouTube. Our YouTube link is there. No, it's not the link. The name is there. IAACPTV. So share most of our video with your friends. Maybe on your leisure time, there are some videos that can also stir your spirit when you are passing through some certain predicament. Those words are there. Most of our videos are not humiliating, rather than it gives us encouragement. It makes us know where we belong in our society. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. Sunset, Sunset Nation, God bless you, God bless you. Tio Lion, God bless you. Tessie Obaze, God bless you, God bless you. Mama, Edith, Benson, Benomba, E. Ozebejo, Gobadia, the Honorable, God bless you in a hurry. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you all in Jesus' name. Hey, the Honorable Comrade Roland, Omozion, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you all. I want to say a big shout out to all the members of the International Association for the Advancement of Colored People, hashtag equality. I thank you for your steadfastness, for keeping this association booming. God bless you all in Jesus' name. Uncle Nat, God bless you. Uncle Fred, God bless you. God bless you all. Mama J. Maris, God bless you. I said it before. Teddy Omos, God bless you. Tonsin, Radia, Jennifer, God bless you. Durosa, God bless you. Please share this video, share this video. We don't hate anybody. We don't want a better society for our people. We want a better society for our people. There are most of us today, even in the world to come, we will not suffer again. We will not suffer again. We will not say we will not go suffer. We will not go over suffer again. It will be for Niger. God bless you all. God bless you all. Thanks very much for your encouraging me. Who said? I take her. Festus Odigie, God bless you. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. Mama Dorcas and family, God will bless you people in a hurry. For your steadfastness, for your caring, for your candiance. Mama Dorcas, God bless you all in Jesus' name. Osamoyi Peter, God bless you. Osasenarogele. Oh yes. Oh, Samuel, gele gele no. Hilary Span, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. Ire, Tekiro mucho todo el mundo. Nemevantao, Eigo Maya we. Godwin blessing, God bless you, God bless you. Good night, God bless you. Please go and like our YouTube. Follow us in our YouTube. Subscribe, please. Subscribe to our YouTube. Muna, encourage us. Because most of the time, all these bloggers, they know they carry this kind of word. They are Wamo Salobo. They know they carry. They are women. They are Uko. Hey. Osa Senaro. Hey. Muna Mahiyo. Eh, Soda. Oh, hey. O tu name is the man, tu name is the man, ne bon wo wo lo. Eh oh! Gracias a Dios. Me ha salvado. Me ha salvado. Comrade Dosahon, a.k.a. the apostle of activism. God bless you in a hurry. Oh yes, Osamakwe. Uyo wo savan o non rekete. Please share this video, share this video. If you are being humiliated for sharing my video, don't worry. God is going to bless you for it. Because Jesus Christ said, he said those that lost their life for the sake of the gospel will gain it. But those that gain their life will lose it. So the reason why I'm one of the most blessed social media presenter, because the word of God. You cannot fight God, because it's the word of God that brought to everyone. It's not my word. I'm not here to humiliate anybody, rather than everybody getting it from the perspective that we need to speak truth to ourselves. Good night, good night, everyone. Au revoir, au revoir. Hasta luego. Buenas noches, todos. Te quiero. mucho todo el mundo. Mi corazón está lleno con mucha alegría y ilusión. Ah, Dios me ha salvado. Cada día cuando yo recuerdo día 2003, yo y mi amigo estaba pensando cómo va a hacer cosas buenas en la vida. Bueno, hay que caminar dentro de tierra. Entonces empezamos hablando, al final ha podido conseguir. Gracias a Dios hoy es un hombre que me va a respetar en toda mi vida. So, we are no longer in where we used to be. That is the most grateful thing of today. So, if you are here in Europe, always thank God that you are here. There are a lot of people who wanted to be here today. They are not here. Things may not be working the way you want it, but I want to prophesy into your life right now. When trouble ends, you become an achiever, not a question mark. When trouble ends, you start living in grace. And when great work for you, you eat what you don't labor for. Today, the grace of God will carry you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Good night, everyone.